Depleted uranium oxide is not water soluble. It's fat soluble. And instead of peeing it out in 6 weeks like the metal, you pee it out in maybe 6 decades. So it's in your body longer. Well, where does it go? The lymphatics. And that doesn't clear too quickly. Decades instead of weeks.
Why does the military deny the health dangers of depleted uranium weapons?
Shooting metal slugs of depleted uranium, for which we had no purpose whatsoever, hitting something and blowing it up. I saw this demonstrated in 1982 in Egypt. We gave a demonstration of solidarity, and we showed the Egyptians how we could blow up target tanks with nothing more than a high-powered metal. When we do that, I mean, this is a fantastic weapon. It's not nuclear. It just burns. But when you do that by weight, half the amount of your DU, depleted uranium, turns to oxides, never to return. So half goes up as dust for us to breathe in the form of depleted uranium oxide. Remember, depleted uranium oxide is still alpha emitter. There's no protection in your lung. And if it radiates and hits the nuclei of the lung cells, that's mutation. Mutations lead to cancer. Or if it goes to your germ cells, your sperm and ovary, birth defects. How in the world does depleted uranium oxide, the alpha emitter, get from your lung to your germ cells? The lymphatics flow everywhere. Once you introduce a mutation, gets its way into the germ cells, carries on to the population, it carries in the line. That's why this thing is a weapon of mass destruction. You're not just affecting the non-combatants, you're affecting the generations. What's the first thing physicians ask when somebody gets a cancer? Does this run in your family? Genetic inheritance, mutations. And that's why we're afraid. And all we're asking is to be a reasonable, go ahead, let's do a survey. Let's not depend on existing or non-existing records of what was brought in. Do a survey. Do not dismiss it that this is not a health effect until you can show me you've taken into account dust. Good luck, because the Miller-REMS things do not talk that much about internal exposure and depleted uranium oxides, which clear the body in decades instead of weeks. Question is, are there signs of mutations, either cancers or birth defects, where these have been openly used? 15 years ago, when we started this panel, these physicians came out of the Balkans, Montenegro, and he said, Dr. Pang, you know we can't prove this. It's very hard to prove, but the rates of birth defects are off the wall. Iraq is reporting the same thing. And recently, I think there's some international movement where the use of these things as weaponry have been condemned, weapon of mass destruction. 2 years ago, they would say, what the heck? But actually, there is a general consciousness not to do this. Now the Iranians, the Iraqi, the Mideastern, the Balkan guys are reporting a lot more birth defects, but quite hard to prove.